Hi, music lovers. My name's Kent, and I'm here to analyze some of my favorite songs and poems. This isn't a reaction channel. You know, we have plenty of YouTubers out there who fake surprise about how good some music is that they supposedly have never heard before. And they give very little rationale about why they think it's good. It's just like, oh, my heart. Yeah. We don't need any more of that. I'm an English guy. So mostly I'll be looking at the lyrics and their meaning, but I'll also look at the music and how that music helps or hinders the delivering of the message. Since this is the first video, I thought I'd start with the shortest song I know. However, short here does not imply inconsequential. The name of that song is Bookends Theme, and it comes from the 1968 album Bookends. Imagine that. By Paul Simon and Garfunkel. The song was written by Paul Simon. This album is the same album that gave us the hits America and the ubiquitous Mrs. Robinson. However, it's always been the title theme that has garnered my attention. Now, if you're unfamiliar, bookends are those heavy sculpture pieces that hold your books upright on a shelf. You know, if you don't have enough books to go from end to end on the shelf, they hold your books up. In short, they provide sort of a parenthesis around a collection. And this song does just that. It bookends the beginning and ending of side one of the album. A side that's full of songs that describe the span of a lifetime, from youth to old age. Hence, again, parenthesis around a collection of years. The first song, of course, is the bookends theme, and then the second song right after that is Save the Life of My Child, representing youth. The last song on side one is the bookends theme, but the song just before that is Old Friends, Old Age. And so we go from youth to old age. The theme begins the album as an instrumental, but it closes side one with 1 minute and 24 seconds of lyrical poignancy. Here is the song.
And what a time it was, it was. A time of innocence, a time of confidences. Long ago, it must be, I have a photograph. Preserve your memories, they're all that's left you.
Time it was, and what a time it was. It was a time of innocence, a time of confidences. Long ago it must be, I have a photograph. Preserve your memories, they're all that's left you. And that's not only all that's left you, that's all there is to the song. But wow, what a sense of sadness and nostalgia and regret is infused in those few words. Now, the song preceding Bookends is Old Friends, which has two old men sitting on a park bench like Bookends, looking back on their lives. Old Friends ends with a sustained high note that sounds eerily like an EKG machine when the heart has stopped beating, and that note melds readily into Bookends. You heard that at the beginning of the song. Bookend starts with a lone acoustic guitar with simple notes, lonely and plaintive. And that's all we get instrumentally, a simple, beautiful string of notes without adornment or addition. It's as if life has been pared to its essentials, as if a life of experiences has distilled itself to simple beauty, as if the meaning of life could be felt in the plucking of a string. And then we get those words, time it was, and what a time it was. It's a phrase we often use to remember the good times, the highlights, the memorable. And that's exactly what Paul Simon meant as he wrote the song. It was a time of innocence, when the world was young and we were young and all the possibilities of life lay before us. It was a time of confidences, which can be thought in two ways. Both youth as a time when one is confident in oneself and one's abilities, likely because we're too ignorant to know any better. But it can also be thought of a time of being a confidant, of having confidants, people we trust to hold our secrets and hopes and dreams and fears before they betray us. Now, the second stanza tells us it's been decades, it must be, since that happy time. Life has hit us, experiences battered us, and like Tennyson's Ancient Mariner, we are older and sadder and wiser. And all that we have of that earlier, younger, happier time is a photograph and some memories. And all that reminds me of Jim Croce's 1972 song, Photographs and Memories, another short song that deals with the same themes. And when we are old and life has stripped us bare, and after friends have died and family has grown and moved away, after we have loved and won and loved and lost, after everything, all we have left are faded pictures and faded memories that grow dimmer with each passing day. And then the song ends on two separate sad notes. I hope you liked this inaugural video. If so, please click the subscribe button and ring that bell. I'd like to know what you think, so say something in the comments. And thank you for watching.